Okay, I put this in because when I started teaching a long time ago, I went across to the College of Education and asked them after I finished my doctorate, okay, so I want to take some classes on how to teach university students. And the chair of the College of the Department of Education, after he was finished laughing, said, well, you know how to do that automatically, that's why you've got a doctorate. And I said, I don't think so. And he said, no, we don't offer any classes, it's too difficult. So I use that to introduce the fact that I'm no expert at university teaching, so don't think I can be the person to go to and answer all your questions. Second condition, I'm not interested per se on e-textbooks. I use e-textbooks in the drug class, and that's because, as most of you are probably aware, we can, I've been to a number of these seminars at Wiley and Cengage and Pearson have given, and any of the books that I want can be dumped into my Blackboard, and then I can use them as I wish, and they've been updated to the newest model, so to speak, like a car, and they have a lot of the little puzzles, bells and whistles, you can underline, and you can make notes, and all that stuff. The only drawback I find is, and I've asked them a number of times when I go to these meetings, when are you going to lower the price? Because it seems to me, if you've mechanized it, you put it there, my students should have next to free access to it. Well, no, because, and then it gets kicked back on, if I wrote the book, what would we pay you with? Because you have to get paid for all that wonderful knowledge you put up there. And I said, well, no, I haven't written any books, and I think the people who have written the books I'm using are either retired or, God forbid, gone to another world now, and so I don't know why you keep on paying for them. The point is, they're not going to listen to that. Eventually, the price will come down, but I wanted to talk about, and was asked to talk about, e-books and the use of them by students. And the e-books that I deal with are in part from geography, where they deal with a specific topic, whereas the students mentioned, I'm one of those horrible people who assigns sections out of books, because I think that the sections are relevant to the material that I'm teaching, and then I'll give an assignment from them. So I pick e-books for both the geography and I teach the S&T class that do that. So I've been given a curriculum, and I know what I have to cover, and then I supplement it in terms of assignments and discussions using ebook material where I can get the library then essentially to pay for multiple copies of books, and out of those books I can pick chapters that I want to deal with. Now, in the past, before I found ebooks, because I've only been doing this for, correct me, maybe only about three years?
No, not even.
No, 2 years maybe, or something like that, yeah. I would find the material, copy it, and if you can say anything, I'll deny that I ever did this. Scan it and upload it to my Blackboard. So I've had the articles there, the students didn't have to pay for it, they just went there. This is because when I was an undergraduate, a graduate student, I had to go to the wonderful reserve room. And the wonderful reserve room, as efficient as it was, usually had one or two copiers, and I had to stand around and copy. Or I might be lucky to take it home with me and go to then what was called Kinko's, which now I think is FedEx, and spend money to have copies made. So it was my expense, which I guess is fine. But in my day and age, undergraduate education was a lot cheaper than it currently is, so. And it didn't cost me 10 cents a page, I think it cost me a couple cents a page. But we all know about all that. So I've been trying to find ways to upload the information to use in the Blackboard system. And ebooks complements that, because I can put the information about what the books are, the students are going to be reading on the syllabus is uploaded to Blackboard. I can have on the syllabus the e-books I'm using, click on it, students can then go directly to the library system, log in, and they will find the books that they want. Then when the assignments come due, I simply say, assignment one, I want you to do this using this book and this book. Now, for the S&T class, I don't want you to think that I've forgotten. I have my own personal copy at great expense that I purchased for myself that I use. And then once I've read the stuff that I want to out of this, I look it up. And people were asking, if you don't mind me jumping ahead for a second. These various places. So if I can find it, if you go to, there are a number of these resources, I just picked one, ebooks.com, look for this book, go under academic, go under geography, geographic thought. Now, you'll notice it's textbook version, 92 bucks. That's too expensive. So I'm not going to use that. So I'll try and find the chapter in it that I want, copy it, scan it, and upload it myself. But for other ones, in physics, for example, or in biology, or whatever it is that I'm interested in, if I can find it there, I will use it. If not, then I go to this trusted source, which Naomi pointed out to me is probably one of the better ones. And I'll do an e-query search for something like, I'm writing a paper on Common Core Standards for the Social Sciences, so I put that as an example. It tells me public libraries, you can go. And the nice thing about it is, there's a mobile. That means there's an app available if you want to download it to your, you know, iPhone. But any of those services are all available that you can use to try and figure out, can I get this book as cheaply as possible before I have to bother Naomi with her doing it? Because she'll look it up for me. But if she's taught me how to do it myself, and it doesn't take me that much time to do it. And so I've learned from her, and then I'll just simply say, what's the possibility of us getting such and such a book? And then we'll go from there. Now, the other thing, I did some research on this before I started doing this, because I know there are skeptics amongst us who are, there's like mixed reviews. I think the gentleman over here pointed out people have a hard time reading the screen. I do. I read an awful lot of stuff on my wonderful little iPhone. I have two computers in my office and at home, and then I have two in my other office in the garage, and I have everything. My whole life is connected. All the stuff that I write, everything is in here. If we ever lose the electric grid, I guess I'll be non-existent like this in those movies. So I did some research into it, and I do know that there's questionable student comprehension and retention. The findings are mixed. There are some anecdotal evidence suggesting students need time to learn how to use the e-books. And I gave this a discussion question where I asked the students in the SAT class, do you really need time to digest, to play with your computer? Because they all seem to sit in class, and I know I'm not supposed to. You'll probably go, well, why don't you just make them shut their phones off and put them in their pocket? I'm not a prison warden or whatever, so they sit there and they're like, doing all this stuff with it, so they must be collecting it. They can do that. So they must comprehend, they must know how to use this stuff. My job is to try and get them to know, okay, take the ideas from there that they're using and apply it to writing a paper or answering a discussion question. And the e-book I find is quite useful. But it's balanced with, if I can't find e-books, I get the hard copy. And I'll donate it, put it on reserve for the library, and usually I forget to pick it up, and so the library gets it. And I have tried to balance the two in the course of my time teaching here. And so I think I tried to be as user-friendly to get the students involved with the books as much as possible to enhance their learning experience. I think there's not much more that I could say other than, in terms of conclusions, I think we need to use ebooks because, I know this is an old reason as well, but other places are using them. And our students need to have exposure to them. Other places are using hardcover books, using the reserve. We can continue to do that. What I'm saying is if we can make more books available at a reduced rate, then we should be doing it as other schools are doing it. Our students should not be left behind in terms of getting access to information. Might not be the best, but that's the responsibility for us as teachers to try and balance out these sources and to use them constructively in terms of lecturing, presenting material. I think the other side of this, in terms of making trade-offs, is that the university library, as most university libraries, are being challenged fiscally. We're not getting as much money. I know for a fact that when I come into the library and ask for journals, they're not available. I have to go to the library alone. These are journals that are essential to geography and to science. Why don't we have them? We just don't have the money. We had some money a little while ago, and it was gone in no time for books. So I like to think that I'm contributing by buying books and when I'm done with them, giving them to the library. But you know, folks, April the 19th, I'll be 65, I'll be old, and shortly thereafter, and then there'll be no source coming in. So I think this is an alternative, and as I say, I don't want to leave any students behind. So essentially, I like them, and I think we should continue to use them and find unique ways in which they can be used. And that's all I have to say. Any questions? Don't ask me anything I don't know.